Avocado Word Church. Welcome to another rendition of Dinner with Dr. Danielle. Today, I have prepped mostly everything that I need to do, but I'm going to be preparing some Denver sole, just simply grilled, some salt and pepper, and I'm gonna have that with some mashed potatoes, which are already pre-cooked, and they are in the microwave. And I'm gonna have that with a side salad of tomato and avocado, which I've already cut up and have sitting off to the side. So let's get started. I've had this actually in the refrigerator. This is the fish, washed and cleaned. And then I put it in this bowl and then I soak it in lime juice for a little while. And that's really to kind of give it a more flavorful taste. And sometimes I found that if I don't do that, I can kind of get like a fishy taste to it because it is such a light and flaky fish. And it's not real meaty, but it's delicious. And I actually, you'll see in there, I have some ice cubes because it's very important to keep the fish cold. And I wanted to make sure that as I was going through and cooking it, that it remains cold. And so what I'm going to do is, you'll see I have several paper towels because I'm going to be simply grilling the fish. And you wanna make sure the fish is dry before you actually put it in the oil. So let's get started. We are working with a Malbec today. And we have D-Nice. So later in the day today than I typically cook. I had some presentations tonight and then telephone calls, and I normally don't eat this late, but we happened to catch D-Nice doing his evening club quarantine after dark. So there's some beauty in that. You'll see that I'm using a aerator on my bottle, which is why it's taking so long to pour. That's a good thing. Cheers, Word Church. Let us get moving and grooving. Yes, so when you pick this up, you'll notice that because it's been sitting in lemon juice, if you look at the meat, you'll see this is the pinkness. Whenever you're buying fish, you wanna make sure it has that nice color of pink. But because it's been sitting in lime juice, you'll see that it's kind of have more of a white flavor, I mean color to it, which makes sense because it's been sitting in lime juice. And then what I'm going to do is use my avocado oil and just kind of go back and forth to cover the bottom of the pan. So the goal is not to deep fry the fish, but simply just kind of grill it. And then I am just going to do a simple salt and pepper, because salt and pepper will be just fine for this fish. It is light and flaky, but whatever you choose for your seasoning will work out just fine. I'm just going to kind of pat that so that I can season the other side. While we wait for that to get going, let me get my towel. And I always like to test to make sure that the oil is hot enough, but not too hot. And by doing that, I just kind of slip my finger in there and put it in there, and you should hear it go sss. Just did that and it didn't go sss. So I know that it's not ready. So why don't we kind of go over, the goal of our dinner tonight. So once I cook the fish, I will lay that on top of a bed of mashed potatoes and then put on the side the salad. There we go. It's popping, locking. You don't want it to be too hot because this will push back on you if it is. Perfect. And the other pieces in here are a little smaller. You'll find out that sometimes when you get the bag from the butcher counter. You're like, where do these little pieces come from? But of course, they entice you with the first big piece. And then you look up, and you got all these other tiny pieces to work with. But that's okay. These are actually more proportionally sized, so this works out even better. And we're just gonna put this in here for just a little bit, not too long. The beauty of fish like this, doesn't take very long to cook. So let me take this one off, put a new paper towel down, and lay these out flat. Make sure you have it flat on the paper towel. Okay, that's the cut right there. Taking me back to my younger days, word church. Can't you understand it? That's when music was good. It wasn't so vulgar. I mean, yeah, some of the lyrics were suggestive, right? But just all in out vulgar? No. No, 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 no. That's when music was good. But you know what? My mom's generation would say the same thing. All right. Now I'm just gonna throw this one because I have room right here on the side. Get this out of the way. Whew. That's my homeboy, Alexander O'Neill, Chi-Town. Homegrown. Well, at least nearby. I actually had a chance to meet him at a record store not far from where I used to live. And he was there to sign records. And I wonder if I still have that photo. I do still have the album. Wouldn't that be cute? The things you remember. All right. You probably can't see this, but as you're cooking the fish, you'll see, I will turn it over once. I usually just try and turn it over once. On the outside, it will really start to get a more consistent pearly white look. That means that it's cooking good. Now, I'm not gonna turn the larger piece over yet, even though that was the first piece that I put in there, because it's not ready yet. But the other one, I'll go ahead and flip. As I said, this does not take very long to cook. And if you overcook these light flaky fish, they actually kind of have like a little rubbery taste to it, and nobody wants that. You see that I'm using a spatula to flip over the fish instead of using something like tongs, because again, the texture is very light. Now I'm gonna get another couple of paper towels out. And what this will do is kind of drain some of the oil that comes off. Okay, I think this is ready to turn. Woo! Yep, very flaky. And it's okay if it falls apart. Quite all right. Still gonna taste delicious. That's what's important. Be so good. All right. Get that going. Now, I already have my mashed potatoes in here. So, I have them on like a minute and a half so that when I'm ready, I can just go ahead and get started and put on the plate. So let's get that plate ready. I am gonna get a bigger plate today. Yes, because I love mashed potatoes. And they are my weakness. I will admit to that. We all have our weaknesses, some more so than others. All right. get that out of the microwave, unlike what I just did. And I'm just gonna put my mashed potatoes. Yes, I'm a little heavy-handed with them. I'm gonna put them right there in the middle. And then I'm gonna take the fish out. Let them drain. This just one more time. Time to pour a little. It's okay. It's gonna be good for good. I'm gonna turn this down a little bit and put the other fish inside. And let that cook. Get this plate out of the way. Whenever you're cooking with meat, whether it's beef or fish or pork or whatever it is, whatever your meat of choice is, it's always important to keep your hands clean and rinse in between, especially if it's poultry. Poultry can really cause issues with salmonella. And so you want to make sure that you have some dish water to the side, and you're constantly keeping up. He is jamming tonight. Keep your hands clean. All right, for church, let's get it going. So I am going to add my salad, kind of just around the side. Sometimes food just tastes better when it looks good, right? Alright. Now, if you're one of those people where you hate food touch, you can arrange your plate any other way you like. And then I'm just going to take a piece there, lay it across. Another piece there. This one little slither came off. And that is it. We have Denver sole over a bed of mashed potatoes with avocado and tomato salad on the side. Very well balanced. Probably you don't need as much starch as I put on my plate, but you can treat yourself every now and then. But you have your vegetables and your protein, and this should fill you up for the evening. So let's give it a try. You'll notice that this is delicious. As you eat it, it has a nice citrusy taste because you let it marinate previously. Let me turn this over. Sorry, church. You let it marinate previously in the lime juice. So, hold on one moment. Keep it turned over. All right. And that's it. Simple, easy Denver sole fish with mashed potatoes and a side salad of tomato and avocado. We did have to use our stove, so sorry about that. But the good thing is it's a little later in the day, so the sun is already set, so that should help. But we didn't have the oven on. That's a plus. Well, I wish everyone a beautiful weekend. Remember to stay safe. Practice social distancing. Wash your hands, especially when you've been out or you've been touching any type of plastics or cardboard. And when should a man wear your mask in public when social distancing is not appropriate? Thank you so much. Have a beautiful day, and I look forward to seeing you all soon. Bye-bye. Cheers.